welcome back. Didn't see you there. So what we're gonna do today? We're gonna be doing ground beef mixed with potatoes. We're also gonna add some pato sauce and some beans to the side for burritos. Okay. I've already washed the potatoes, so now we're gonna prep everything. All right. Stay tuned. Alright, so the hard part's over. We're gonna cut all the potatoes. I tried to cut it down to the smallest pieces I could. Two potatoes, we're gonna mix that with the ground beef. We're gonna add the pato sauce into the pan. First, we're gonna cook the potatoes, make sure they get as soft as they can before we put the ground beef in. We start mixing it together, and then we should be good. We're gonna prep the pan here, put some oil, a little oil in here, get it centered up, and then should be good. Should be super sticky. Yes, this is time consuming to make, you know. But it's worth it, you know. I was craving these tacos for a while now. You can't really get these type of tacos unless you really request it from like a taco shop. But ground beef, you know, potatoes, you got some lettuce, you got the salsa, and some tomatoes. And it's great, it's a good home cooked meal. And it's a certain taste you get that you can't really get anywhere else. Cool. Used to have this a lot when growing up, you know. Dad will make it, mom will make it. And I love it. Pretty close to the, you know, picadillo style is what you call picadillo. I think picadillo, you add a couple other things, but for the most part, that's what it is. It's like a picadillo style stew, you know. And it's great. To everybody, it doesn't cost them out of the potatoes. I mean, there's a cheap ground beef that was $5 for the ground beef. Salt, pepper, all you really need. And tortillas. And it's great. So, yeah, so the potatoes are gonna cook for a little bit to get soft. You don't want them hard. And then, if we need to, we can even break it up a little bit more to smaller pieces. And then we add the ground beef. Ground beef cooks fast. So once these are getting a little bit softer and brown, then keep it on low. Medium low. I'm gonna burn them. And then I will add the ground beef, and then we'll add the tapatio, or the pato sauce. Sorry, not tapatio, pato. Different type of salsa. And then we'll have a finished product. Okay, so let this dip a little bit. Simmer. We'll come back. So what we did here, the camera didn't capture it, but we put the potatoes in here to start cooking before we put the ground beef, because we don't want the potatoes to be too hard. While they're cooking, and the ground beef takes a little bit of time to cook, so we'll do these first. And once they start getting softer, we can probably cut them a little bit smaller if we need to. And let it sit there. A little bit. Okay, so I added a little bit of more oil here. So just FYI, this is the first time me ever doing this, so I really don't know what I'm doing. I just kind of using basic cooking, thoughts on how to do this process. Potatoes first, cook, they took longer because they're harder. Cook them first, add the ground beef. As that's cooking, you add in the freaking pato sauce. We're gonna put the beans first because it's cooked fast. So while we're doing that, we'll be cooking the beans separately. We fry beans. A little kicker. So it should be fine. Let that do its thing. Close. Alright. So now we probably start adding some ground beef. This is a little bit hard, so hopefully it has enough time to simmer down here. And that's soft enough. It'll break up as it's in there, getting hot. And I'll add more seasoning too. Maybe more salt and more pepper. As it transitions here. We might not even need all of that. Maybe not. We'll see right now. So let that do its thing. Turn this on. Keep that low. Do your thing there. Add this beef to cook inside. Not at all anymore. So yeah, any hints, tips, tricks, you guys can let me know. Get some comment and tell me how much I screwed up, which is fine. I will always be the rookie cook, always. All right. Bear with me, people. All right. So, this is ready. There. It should be fine, guys. It's food. As long as you're not overcooking or burning anything, everything should come out. Pretty fine. There we go. This. I don't put too much, but it's fine. Sit. We'll come back to it. Alright. Alright, cool. All right, so once I broke it all down, it started to come out and look a little bit better once I got the meat to break down and not be as hard. And then potatoes doing its thing, it's still getting cooked. Once all the meats, I feel like it's not pink anymore, then I'll add in the pato sauce at the end. give it that last flavor. The beans, they cook pretty fast, so that was already done. That's ready for the, just a kind of like an appetizer, side dish. But yeah, this is pretty much what it's gonna look like. I mean, it's like a stew, potato stew, picadillo, potato, beef, sauce, combination. And it's really good, I really like it, I always like it. You know, lettuce, you know, you got tomatoes, to the taco, to the burrito. I'm gonna keep it simple, I didn't go and buy lettuce, so that's my bad. But I'm just gonna do just the product and a burrito. And the pasta sauce itself adds that final flavor, so that's pretty much all it really needs. You know, pepper and salt, a little bit of oil, some water, and salt to the beans. So those are easy and those are done. That's it. Like I said, it is a little bit time consuming. You know, this is like a meal you cook for the family. You know, I mean, 10 minutes to cut up the potatoes and peel them and do all that. And the cooking another 10, 15 minutes maybe, depending on your flame. That, you know, a couple of minutes, not too bad. And it's good, it's great. Like I said, it doesn't cost much, but the prep is what takes the most time. So let that sit for a little bit, and we'll add in the pato sauce. And we can probably add it right now. And then we'll let it sit simmer. Couple more minutes and it should be done. Oh yeah. So let that blend in. Pato sauce, they have two different brands of the pato sauce. They have a jalapeno picante type, and this is the regular hot tomato salsa style version. And it's great. 10 bucks, I think you can complete the whole meal. Eat the whole family. I have some extra. Instead of buying just one burrito for 10 bucks at the taco shop, 10 bucks you can feed the whole family. So, like I said, you gotta put in the effort and prep it, cook it, and yeah. That's what we do. I probably make this kind of like a plate, so I'll put the beans in the corner, this in the corner, and then the tortillas, and you can kind of just pick and grab how you like it, you know, on your own accord. Or burritos, whichever. I mean, feeding the kids, and you prep the burritos for them, so. Alright, it looks pretty good. We're gonna let it sit for a little bit, let it do its thing, and then we'll come back. Alright, peeps. I think we're just about there. So, it's pretty good. It looks like it's supposed to look like, smells like what it's supposed to smell like. Letting everything kind of just blend in. Make sure everything's cooked, all the potatoes are cooked thoroughly. The blend, make sure the beef is cooked. Tortillas are pretty much already done. And yeah. Smells like parents' house, 1989. So, yeah, this is pretty much the finishing touches here, last phase, and then we'll do the prep. So you hear me, people? We have the beef potatoes with the beans and tortillas. Simple little process. Well, not really simple, but you know, you get the point. Now you can enjoy it. Thanks.